So you have a form, and then the next logical step in a real-world application is to validate the information that a user is submitting to that form and then be able to display any errors to the user if that information does not match the format that you expect it to be in. Let's take a 3-minute high-level overview of how to make that happen within Laravel and some things that you might want to keep in mind. Using a starter kit like Laravel Breeze, some validation techniques have already been implemented on pages for you, like registration or login. You have this backend validation when I click the register button that sends an error message back to the front end that you can display to your users. In this case, the validation that it did not match the confirmation field. So how does this happen? In this validate method, we can pass any specific validation rules to an individual field within our form request. That password confirmation validation that we saw is because of this confirmed rule. In this case, because there is a password and a password confirmation field, we're saying that this should be required and also confirmed. In addition to these custom validation rules that Laravel gives you out of the box that are separated by these pipe characters, you can also pass in custom rules as well. For example, the default password rules that Laravel provides out of the box. In this case, a bunch of different methods to make sure that your password is secure. There are a ton of available validation rules that Laravel has out of the box that you can use for pretty much every single circumstance. And while we can't go over every single one, there are a couple that I want to point your eyes to. The active URL rule uses the DNS get record PHP function in order to check if a URL is actually active. Adding the sometimes rule to your list means that you're only validating that specific field if that field is present in the data that's being validated. And then lastly, the unique rule is incredibly helpful. You can check if a field that's under validation exists within the given database table or column. So when a field that is being validated returns with an error, Laravel automatically redirects the user to the previous page and flashes the errors to the session. While displaying these errors is different whether you're using Blade, Livewire, or Inertia, the errors variable is within that flashed session. Laravel Blade also includes an @error directive so that you can quickly determine if a specific field has an error message. And in Inertia, the use form helper includes an errors value that you can use within your application. For example, errors.email. Publishing the language files with PHP Artisan Lang Publish creates a validation page where you can customize the default error messages within an application. For example, if we wanted to customize that confirmation message that we saw at the beginning of the video, we could just change it here. There's so much more that we could cover within validation, even outside of all of the rules that Laravel gives. From being able to create custom form requests so your validation logic is separated from your controllers, or something like creating a special validator itself. Your application needs to stay safe and secure, which means your forms need to stay safe and secure. And that means validating any and all information that is being passed to those forms from your users, because we can't really trust anyone on the web, can we? So stay validated.